Hi, I'm Mary, I'm an environmental consultant and welcome to my sustainable food production channel. This particular video is part of my ammonia emissions from agriculture series, and today I'm going to focus on the nitrogen cycle, specifically what happens when organic manures are applied to land, be that arable or grassland. By organic manures, this includes solid manures, liquid slurries, digestates from anaerobic digestion, and other manures as well. This video could also be useful for anyone who needs to know about the nitrogen cycle generally. So, around 90% of ammonia emissions are from agriculture, including all stages of the livestock production system, which you can see on the diagram. Firstly, during livestock production itself, both housing and diet can contribute. Secondly, from stored organic manures, and at this point, digestates from anaerobic digestion would also be included. And finally, during application to land. So today, my focus is on ammonia emissions following application to land. And I have separate videos where I talk about the other aspects shown here. Ammonia emissions from organic manures come initially from the readily available nitrogen within them, often abbreviated to RAN. RAN is the nitrogen that is potentially available for rapid crop uptake. The three main RAN compounds are uric acid, ammonium, and nitrate. And the uric acid is only found in poultry manure. Ammonium is the main readily available nitrogen source in animal manures and slurries and digestates. What happens to the nitrogen when organic manures are applied to land? The organic nitrogen portion of organic material is shown on the left. This is released slowly over a period of months to years, whereas the ammonium or uric acid is more readily available to the crop. Some of the ammonium on the soil surface may be converted to ammonia gas. Volatilisation, as shown in red, is the name for this conversion of ammonium to ammonia gas, which is released to the atmosphere. This diagram shows two scenarios. On the left, the slurry or manure has been surface broadcast, which is the main technique for applying manures and slurries. A lot of ammonia is being emitted. On the right-hand side, the slurry has been applied with a low emission spreading technique, such as an injector or trailing shoe, with much lower ammonia emissions. A lot more ammonia will be released when the slurry remains on the surface, and also more ammonia will be released on warm and windy days. Now, back to the nitrogen cycle. As well as organic manures, there are other inputs of nitrogen into the soil, as shown in the blue boxes. Firstly, ammonium and nitrate within the rain contribute to the soil nitrogen cycle. Secondly, biological fixation, which is the conversion of atmospheric nitrogen to ammonia via bacteria called rhizobia. These can be found in the soil and also in root nodules of legumes such as clover, peas and alfalfa. Then nitrogen fertilisers, which are generally ammonium and nitrate. And finally, nitrogen from crop residues, slowly breaking down over time, but is mainly organic nitrogen to begin with. When organic manure is added to the soil, the organic nitrogen within the manure will gradually over time be converted to ammonium via mineralisation. This is the process when soil organisms break down organic nitrogen to ammonium. These include bacteria and fungi. As it's a biological process, rates of mineralisation vary with soil temperature, moisture, and the amount of oxygen in the soil. Nitrification is the process by which microorganisms convert ammonium to nitrate to obtain energy. This is a very quick process as compared to mineralisation. Immobilisation, on the other hand, this is when nitrate and ammonium are taken up by soil organisms and returned back into the soil microbial biomass pool. And therefore, the nitrogen becomes unavailable to crops. This reduces the loss of nitrates by leaching. A small portion of the ammonium may be directly absorbed by the plant roots. Ammonium is also converted by microorganisms to nitrate by a process called nitrification, which is a quick process. Oxygen is needed in the soil and generally temperatures of at least 5 degrees. Nitrate is very soluble and mobile in the soil and is the most available form of nitrogen, so the majority of plant nitrogen uptake is nitrate. When crops are not growing, much of the nitrate will not be taken up. Instead, rainfall, especially over winter, will wash a large portion of this nitrate out of the soil before the crop can use it. This is called nitrate leaching. Often this can reach groundwater. In the EU and UK, the limit for nitrates in drinking water is 50 milligrams per litre. Delaying organic manure applications until late winter or spring will reduce nitrate leaching and increase the efficiency of crop utilisation of manure nitrogen. This is particularly important for organic materials with a high content of readily available nitrogen. Compared to nitrate, ammonium does not readily leach, and it's weakly held by the organic matter and clay in the soils. Talking about the nitrogen cycle would not be complete with also considering other gaseous emissions. Denitrification is when nitrogen is lost to the atmosphere through the conversion of nitrate in the soil to gaseous forms of nitrogen, such as nitric oxide, nitrous oxide, and dinitrogen gas, N2. Denitrification occurs in poorly drained or compacted soils. So when the soil is saturated with water, the bacteria may use nitrate as an oxygen source as there is no air. Volatilisation, emissions of ammonia, are more likely in light soils that are alkaline and conditions that favour evaporation, including hot weather and windy conditions. Also, this conversion from ammonium to ammonia is higher for organic manures and urea fertilisers that are surface applied and not incorporated within the soil. And so this is the full nitrogen cycle. The nitrogen cycle shows how nitrogen moves through the soil to the crops, water and the air. Understanding the nitrogen cycle can help growers to make the best use of manure and fertilisers to meet crop needs while safeguarding the environment. So rapid soil incorporation of organic manures and solid digestate following application to tillage land will reduce ammonia emissions. For liquid slurry and digestate and other organic materials, low emission techniques such as band spreading or injection can effectively reduce ammonia emissions following land application. This slide just shows some useful links for further information on reducing ammonia emissions. And finally, I have some more videos in the Farm Ammonia Reduction series, including my general overview of ammonia emissions from agriculture. And my other videos, including this one today, together consider how to reduce ammonia emissions in each step of livestock production in more detail. My other video on application of organic manures focuses on low emission application options. So let me know what topics you feel will be useful in the future and the topic of sustainable food production. Thanks for listening today. Ammonia.